Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to another video, and got some Final Fantasy 12 units to review. So, start off with Fossler, who apparently is getting a lot of love on Reddit, but not so much love for me. Well, first of all, TMR is okay. 10% magic damage taken, which is nice when you get revived. Because okay, it'll come back and then we'll get overridden anyways. And then says TMR. So bad. 25 main eaters, 2 OP guys. 25% main eaters, 2 OP. And that 20% spirit, ooh boy. It's so good. Big Kappa, by the way. It's not very good. So, he does have some nice things about him, like 2 mitigations in 1 move. Unfortunately, he's similar to Bash, where he can only use certain moves with a dual cast. His chaining is wasted, by the way, because it's not based off of his spirit. It's based off of his attack, but who cares? Who cares about his chaining moves if you can't base off the spirit? We don't weigh too much out of his way to become a chainer and a tank at the same time. It's just terrible. So at least he can, you know, do some buffing, you know, stuff like that. Nice. People are saying that he's better than Cecil. Like, that's a joke, dude. He's definitely not better than Cecil, though. You know, he has like a dispel, which is nice. He has mitigation, which is nice. You know, cover, which is pretty nice. The mitigation is okay. Never said damage mitigation for 2 turns. But it's only 7%, and it's physical instead of magical, so. Yeah. He has like all this TDH, but like who cares about this TDH, because like I just mentioned, if you can't build it for spirit, then what's the point? This is so useless. And why would you want to have attack anyways if you're a magic tank? It doesn't make any sense, guys. This guy is definitely not better than Cecil. His stats are not even that good. As you can see here, his stats are not that high. Most of it's an attack. And his Limit Burst actually, despite it being pretty good, there'll be a lot of situations where you might not want to have him provoke. Because you need someone else to do that job instead of him. So, this is actually not as good as it seems sometimes. People on Reddit were quick to judge as saying this was too OP. This is much better Limit Burst than Cecil's. It's just ludicrous, dude. You don't always want him to be provoking, so his Limit Burst is actually pretty bad. He doesn't seem like a very good unit, and it shows because he's not a Summon Fest unit, guys. He is UOC-able. So that means that he's just not going to be very good. They made him into a convoluted mess because they didn't make him, you know, base his attacks off of spirit. They didn't give him spirit TDH or anything like that to make him want to equip a great sword. It's just not very good. It's just all around not very good. So, sorry to say, despite what people said, he's not very good. And he's definitely not better than Cecil. No way. No way. I will disagree with that forever. This guy does not beat Cecil. His STMR is a joke, by the way. Anyways, on to Ashe, who is a very good mage, we'll be getting into. And yes, like I said in my news video, yes, her TMR is good. But, like I said in my news video, It's just better to equip killer rods. There's a lot more killer rods in the game now than there were a while ago. For people on global who might not think that this is like the bee's knees, it's actually not really, because you'd rather equip two rods that, and at least one rod that gives killers, so that already kind of butts out one of the bonuses that you would get from this TMR. So it's not as good as it seems, guys. It just isn't. Most people can't even equip, most mages can't equip swords anyways. But it'd be good for hybrids. Hybrids would like that HP. So this TMR is just okay. Sure, it has only one break, and has magic mitigation tied to it. I mean, it's just, I'm not feeling it. I'm really not feeling it. Only magic break, whereas your breaker can just, you know, break whenever they want, so not really that good. So she does have some, you know, chaining capabilities, of course, as you would expect, but not, she does not have that really memorable healing move as she had before, at least not yet. So we're gonna go down, these are on her unlock moves, and look at that, she actually does have it, guys. She actually does have it. Look at that. It's the same, it's like the same as when, you know, she was chaining, so she chains when she heals, which is very nice. Seems like a lot of her other moves seem to be doing the same thing. Ununite all over again, I guess, with these imperils again. Not sure why we're going back to doing those, but it is what it is. And yeah, it looks like it just does the same thing for each one. For each one that gets unlocked, it's, and it costs Lunapurse crystals as well to use these. That's not that interesting to me. I'm not really sure why they have to cost Lunapurse crystals, because honestly, yes, she's a very strong mage, but she is definitely not the top mage in the game. Did they think that she was the strongest mage in the game? Because she's definitely not. She's already been mathed out. In fact, I can probably find that a little bit later, but she's not the strongest mage in the game, unfortunately. But she will probably be stronger than whatever you have, unless you have Dark Bahamafina. If you have Dark Bahamafina, then you don't have to worry about anything, obviously. But yeah, she's not the strongest, but she has some strong unlock moves that are available on turn 3. It's available for one use, so think of it like Kimono Fina, where she's able to use those moves once and then they go away. But they don't go away until you use them, so that's pretty good. Also, her MP costs are all over the place. Like this move. 529 MP to use this move. Sure, 90% damage magic mitigation is very strong, but that's a lot of MP to use. That's probably almost your whole mana pool. Or maybe not even do it. I don't know. Most mages can't get over 1000 MP, but that's still a whole lot. And her cooldowns cost 100. Her stronger chaining costs 60. It's expensive. There's some expensive stuff going on. So our main chain move obviously is going to be Fake Bolting Strike, not Mystic Cross. Yeah, it looks like, yeah, it's all Bolting Strike. So yeah, the Lunapurse, by the way, is pretty good. But it only gives 100% magic instead of 300%. But it is pretty strong. I'm not sure why it's only lightning though, because she has other elements, but I guess lightning is her main focus, so apparently her Lunapurse is very strong, and that is because she has some Lunapurse damage in her kit. Here it is, 50%, maybe she has more. Now, there's a lot of passives here, and you might say, why? Like, look at all these passives, but some of them are kind of useless, like equipping a shield. Are you really going to be equipping a shield on your mage? No. Because it doesn't give any magic bonuses, really. So are you really going to be equipping, you know, shields? No, probably not. gets a lot of passives from equipping shields, but it just seems useless. She does have a lot of magic for TGH though, I'll say that much. In fact, she has, whoa, she has 300% TDH? Whoa, what? Here? I mean, magic TDH is kind of useless nowadays compared to true to wield, but look at this. She has 300% TDH, which is actually kind of insane. That is one thing that's going on about her that's pretty crazy. However, like I said, she's not the top dog, despite what it may appear, like with 300% TDH, which is pretty crazy. It's not gonna be, it's not enough to make her into the top dog. She is a top dog, just not the top dog. So, with all of her unlock moves and things that you can only use sometimes, apparently this triple cast you can only use unique selection only, whatever that means. I guess you can only use certain moves. That's unfortunate. Just have auto revive, but she even have dual cast. Yeah, she does, so she could be like a slight healer, just like Rem could be. That's a thing that could happen if you wanted it to. So what do I grade Rossler? A D plus. I'll give him a D plus. Only because he does have a lot of good nice tanking, but it's just there's too much bad stuff in this that I just don't like. Like the chain, like it's all over the place. The chaining doesn't make any sense because he's not based off of spirit, so you're forcing yourself to focus on attack and being TDH when he's supposed to be a magic tank. You're losing out a lot of spirit. So there's that. So he's getting a D plus from me, and also Ash is definitely getting an A. I think an A. She has a lot of things about her that are, you know, unique. She's not just another DPS, she has a lot of support capabilities as well, like healing, re-raise, raise. 300% TDH, by the way, just saying. 300%. That's insane. That's never been done before, ever, on any unit until now. So yeah, D plus for Rossler, A for Ash, which is pretty amusing, because you get it. Anyways, let's go ahead and look at our damage numbers now. So as you can see here, this is not my spreadsheet, by the way. As you can see here, Ash is not even close to the top in terms of overall damage, not even nearly close to Dark Bahama Fina's, like I was saying. And she's actually not even stronger than Rem. So there's that. But she does have respectable damage, just not enough. What the heck's going on? Anyways, so yeah, as you can see here, she's not a top dog by any means, but she has some strong capabilities about her, which is pretty nice. That's fine. I would ignore the Kurosami thing, by the way, because his chaining is broken on the JP side. It doesn't work that well. The global side, he'll be a lot better. Anyways, this is about Ash. So anyways, come on. Yeah, this is, I don't know if this is going to show up. No, but it's not. It's not going to show up very well. So I think we're at the end of the review. If you watch all the way through, type in hashtag FF12. FF12 will be the keyword for the ending of this video. If you watch all the way through, what do you guys think? Am I wrong about Vossler, apparently? I mean, he could be good. If you don't need, you know, someone else to provoke, I guess, but it just seems kind of bad for me. Anyways, guys, let me know what you guys think. Down below in the comments. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. Please consider liking the video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.